closer here. Okay, perfect. So, let's see. I think the first thing that we're going to be doing is giving you a bit of a clean. It says on the paper that your voice box is broken and the eyes are malfunctioning a little bit. So, I'm going to do the best I can here. So, let's just move this to the side a little bit. Good. Okay, then. So, let's see. I'm also going to be brushing the hair. Doing a bit of a polish, and then also it's already leaking. I do need to get a new one, but as long as it does the job, I am. Let's just go in, get rid of any particles that are stuck here. Presuming that the package you were in must have tumbled, so. Okay. But they did design you very nicely. Of course, I wouldn't expect anything less. So, you will have to be repainted, but I will not be able to do that myself. I do not have the right paints here. So I will be sending you on to one of my wonderful colleagues. Okay. Now, I don't know how sentient you are, but let's just pretend that you are. I just want to reassure you that everything will be fine and you will be looking not only as good as new, but much better. Okay. I'm gonna go both ways here. Okay. Also dusting off any other part that looks like it needs a bit of TLC. No. We don't want to apply this directly. I think I'm going to go in with this brush and then apply it to these little tails here. Don't want to apply too much. And now we press these together. Made sure to use the solution with the finer magical particles, just so that it wouldn't scratch the beautiful work that has been created on your face. So good. Now let's see if the correspond properly here. Can you bend them properly? Yes. The other side. Okay. Wonderful. Got to go in one more time. Just for a final wash. Always a very important part, which I feel is sometimes neglected, both on dolls, animatronics, humans. They tend to pay too much attention to that area, which can sometimes lead to depending on you're working with a certain buildup of oil or wax or maybe resin, depending on what formula you used, and also taking into consideration that there are also different temperatures and weather conditions depending on where you will be sent to, for instance. So we want to make sure that everything looks absolutely perfect. Start the actual polishing. I think we should start with the actual repair section. I think the voice box can simply just be turned around a few times. If we just have a bit of a. Okay. Just gonna pull this open here. Make sure everything is even. The light should be popping on in 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, perfect. Wonderful. Okay. So, step one of the repair in your face is done. Wonderful. In here are doing. Okay. Good. I'd say that just needs a bit of a tightening, like with the voice box. Worry about that. Okay. there's anything else that I can see right now. I mean, the letter did say it was pretty much only that. Let's see if the wiring is somehow connected to your hair. I don't think so. We will detangle it anyway. Gonna go in very gently again on the sides here. Perfect, and I think we can go over to polishing. Right, I'll bring the things in. I want to use a slightly different texture for this. Something with less indentations, just to quickly buff up the surface. So we're just going to apply this here. fabric first or brushing? I'm gonna go with brushing, I think. I'll be right back. Okay. Just going to use very gentle strokes here. Since your hair is very fine. That was very quick. Okay, let's put that to the side. Just add some more information in here. So, punched. What do you think of that? So, going to measure the face. Also see if we can drape some fabric over you, because that was supposed to be changed. We wanted a more modern version. Okay. I suppose it will be one of those models where you can change the outfits, so we won't have to worry about that too much. Just make it very loose fit. In that case, I do need a new piece of paper. Okay. So, I'm going to write down measurements just in case they need something for either a future model or for you. Don't want to upgrade something again. Let's see. Yeah, that would work. swatchesy, mouthy. Look with upper lip and lower lip as well. See, that makes a big difference. Look. Okay. Now we're gonna go with perfect. And I also want to measure distance from one eye to the other, going above the nose bridge. Good. Okay, let's also measure just right around the face. I don't think we need any other measurements besides these. I do need to write down the full number up here, which is located on the side. Good. Okay, and change. And then we just sign. Okay. And set that off. I could put some swatches together. Good. Now, first, we'll get rid of these strands. That will not do. Okay. But a little too magician, in my opinion. But could keep it as a runner-up, I suppose. Putting it down here, and of course this one. I do find this one to be more visually interesting. However, this could be a little too harsh on the skin. I still had my pins. Can't find them here. So we shall take these two and then put a little tag on here. I'm going to be sending these out, and then we will be sending you to Shanny. Sorted for the next step. So, right, I'm going to just press around here so that you go into snooze mode.